Yes, good morning children. Today we will discuss this midpoint theorem. Very important topic here in quadrilaterals. This is midpoint theorem, that is theorem 8.9. What is this theorem? What is the statement of this theorem? Prove that line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and it is half of it. Means what is given in a triangle? D is the midpoint. E is the midpoint. D is joined. We have to prove that then D is parallel to BC. We have to show D is parallel to BC and D is half of BC. So what is given? What is midpoint theorem? In a triangle, when midpoints of two sides are joined, then this line DE is parallel to the third side BC and DE is half of BC. So I will write what is given part here. Given is triangle ABC. AD equal to DB and AE equal to EC. Means AD equal to DB, that means D is the midpoint. AE equal to EC, that means E is the midpoint. It is given. What to prove? DE is parallel to BC and DE is half of BC. To prove this, I will do construction here. What is construction? Produce this DE to F such that DE equal to EF. Join FC. So this is construction. Produce DE to F such that DE equal to EF. Join CF. So this is construction. Now this equal to this. This side equal to this side because it is given that E is the midpoint. So this equal to this. You will prove by SAS these two triangles are congruent. You see two triangle in triangle AED, in triangle AED and triangle CEF. In these two triangles you see AE equal to EC. It is given because E is the midpoint. DE equal to EF, it is by construction. And angle AED equal to angle CEF, vertically opposite angles. Therefore by SAS congruence, triangle AED is congruent to triangle CEF. If they are congruent, therefore I will write AD equal to CF. AD equal to CF. It is CPCT by AD equal to this is by CP. See corresponding parts of congruent triangles. If two triangles are congruent, therefore corresponding sides are equal. AD equal to CF. But you know AD equal to what? AD equal to DB. It is given from these two results. What you will get? AD will get cancelled. CF equal to DB. And I will write CF is parallel to DB because angle 1, you can say angle 1 equal to 2. Angle 1 equal to, or this is 1. Angle 1 equal to angle 2. I will write CF is parallel to BD. Why? Because angle 1 equal to 2. This is also CPCT. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles. But they are alternate angles. Therefore, I will write CF parallel BD. So, CF is parallel to BD and CF is equal to BD. Therefore, BCFD. Therefore, I will write quadrilateral BCFD. BCFD is a parallelogram. BCFD is a parallelogram. Because one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. So, this side is equal to this side. And this is parallel also. This is parallel also. Therefore, we can say BCFD is a parallelogram. So, if it is a parallelogram, therefore opposite sides are equal. I will write therefore DF is parallel. Therefore, DF is parallel to BC. Or you can say DF or DE is the same line. DE is parallel to BC. So, in this way, you have proved this part. One part. D is parallel to BC because DF is parallel to BC. This is opposite sides of a parallelogram. We have proved that BCFD is a parallelogram. So DF is parallel to BC, or you can say D is parallel to BC. What is another part? If they are parallel, they are also equal. So DF equal to BC. DF equal to BC. You can write opposite sides of a parallelogram. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. So instead of DF, I will write DF. I will write DE plus EF, because DE plus EF is again the DF, the whole line segment DF equal to BC. So it is, this implies twice DE. I will write DE for this EF. EF is also equal to DE by construction, equal to BC. This implies twice DE equal to BC. So DE is half of BC. So this was the second part here. You have proved DE is half of BC. So what is midpoint theorem? If in a triangle, the midpoints of two sides are joined, you can say then this line is parallel to BC and this line is half of BC. So you can use this midpoint anywhere in this exercise here in quadrilaterals, exercise number 8.3. So D and E are the midpoints in a triangle. You can directly say then DE will be parallel to BC and DE is half of BC. So this is midpoint theorem. Thank you.